and the worst of Shudra. Each one of them is good also. But when you mix them, then you get the worst apparently, not the best of them. Otherwise, Bada Swami is a Vedavyasa, Badarayana, he's a son. He was glorifying. How? He was son of fisherwoman, you know. So, and he was son of the sage on one hand, Parasara with a fisherwoman. Imagine, what a combination. So that is why they say never ask the origin of a Rishi, you know. Because all Rishis had origin like that. And that's never becoming of them. But then still, Vedavyasa got the best of both. And so he has that courage, all of coming from the fisherman class. And he has all the nobility, you know, coming from the sage. Thank God that he inherited the best of both. Otherwise you can inherit the worst of both, you know. So generally they would fear that whenever this kind of combination takes place, perhaps the child may attain, get the worst of both. So this Ugraha, he is worst of Kshatriya and worst of Shudra. Kshatra Sudra Svahava Pumaan Ugraha Ityartha So Ugraha Pratigrunyatyapi. And so you should not receive gift from him, that also he receives. Tatra means Tasyam Deshi Vada means what? Vadam Ashankam Vada Nimittam Ashankam. So whenever he goes into any quarters or in unknown place where there is an ashanka, always a doubt, you know, or fear of death. Vada ashanka ityartha yam dishameti taskaradhyakirnam. So when there is a place which is infested by thieves and so forth, tasyam dishi vada ashanka, then there is a fear. So how comes the fear of these thieves? Because of the love for life. So then also, the fear also reflects nothing but love for life. Tach etat sarvam, footnote number 4, ayajya yajanadikam pranasya priyatve bhavati. All of this reflects nothing but the love for life that a person has. Pranasyeva samrat kamahe samrat, this is all done for the love of life. Tasmat pranavi samrat paramam brahma, therefore he samrat prana is param brahma. So knowing this, evam vidvan etad upasate, knowing this manner, when the person meditates, then his meditation also becomes more efficacious. Nayanam prano jahadi samanamanyat, he gets the fear of the prana, the creatures. And so all of that is to understood samanam as before, as in the previous passage. Ugro jati vishya adi shabdana mlecha gana gruhyate, and again where is that adi? Ugradehe. And so patitadikam, there is one adi, ugradehe, there is also an adi, ugradi. Adi shabdena mlecha gana gruhyate, mlecha. There is a definition for all of this, mlecha, who is mlecha, who is chandala. So what combination produced chandala, what, there are definitions or names for all these things. Okay, so that is a meditation upon the prana. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah Hari Om.
The next Kandika. Your avaj moto karo. So, chalish mani ka? Okay. Yadeva te kaschita braveer Tatshanava mete Abraveen me Barkuho Varshani Takshurvai brahmede यथा मातृमान् पितृमान् आचार्यवान् ब्रूयात्, तथा तद्वार्ष्णो ब्रवीत्, चक्षुर्वै ब्रह्मेति, अपश्यतो हि किं स्यादिति, अब्रवीत्तुरेतस्यायतनम् प्रतिष्ठा न मे ब्रवीदिते एकपाद्वा एतत् सम्राडिते सवैनो ब्रूहियाग्निवल्क्य चक्षुरेवायतनम् आकाशः प्रतिष्ठा सत्यमित्येनदुपासीत का सत्यतायाग्निवल्क्य चक्षुरेव सम्राडिति होवाच चक्षुषा वै सम्राट् पश्यन्तमाहुः अद्राक्षीरिते साह अद्राक्षमिते तत्सत्यं भवति चक्षुर्वै सम्राट् परमं ब्रह्म नैनं चक्षुर्जहाते सर्वाण्येनं भूतान्यभिक्षरन्ते देवो भूत्वा देवानप्येते एवं विद्वानेतदुपास्ते हस्तशुभं सहस्रं ददामीति होवाच जनको वैदेहः सहोवाच याज्ञवल्क्यः पिता मे मन्यत नाननु शिष्य हरेतेति यदेव ते कश्चित् अब्रवीत् तत् शृणवामेति वाट् एवर् एनी आचार्य मे टोल्ड् यू हे जनक प्लीस् लेट् मी हियर् दट् अब्रवीन् मे वर्कुः वर्ष्णि सो वार्ष्णः इन्फेक्ट् या लेट्स् अब्रवीन् मे बर्कुः वार्ष्णः नाट् वर्ष्णिः वार्ष्णः सो बर्कुः वार्ष्ण द सन् आफ् वृष्ण इस् काल् वार्ष्ण सो हि डिड् इन् डीटेल् मी चक्षुर्वै ब्रह्मेति चक्षु इस् ब्रह्म इन् दिस् केस् चक्षु मीन्स् दि प्रिसैडिङ्ग् डेटि आफ़् द फेकल्टि आफ़् सीयिङ्ग् दट् ईस् आदित्य सन् इस् ब्रह्म यथा मातृमान् पितृमान् आचार्यवान् ब्रूयात् तथा तद्वार्ष्णो ब्रवीत् जनका इट् इस् क्वैट् रैट् जस्ट् एस् मातृमान् पितृमान् आचार्यवान् वन् हू हेज़् दि रैट् कैण्ड् आफ़् कल्चर् एण्ड् ट्रैनिङ्ग् एण्ड् एजुकेशन् फ्रोम् दिस् रिसोर्सस् एण्ड् देर् वन् हू इस् संस्कृत सो वन् हू हेज़् दट् कल्चर् संस्कृत हियर् हौ हि वुड् से सो इस् दट् नालेजबल् पर्सन् तत् वार्ष्णः तथा तद्वार्ष्ण ब्रवीत् दट् इस् औ दट् वार्ष्ण टोल्ड् यू चक्षुर्वै ब्रह्मेति द चक्षु और् ऐस् फेकल्टि आफ़् सीयिङ्ग् और् दि प्रिसैडिङ्ग् डेट् इस् ब्रह्मेति इन्डीड् अपश्यतो हि किं स्यात् इति सो वाट् केन् अ पर्सन् हु डस् नाट् सी वाट् केन् यु गेट् वाट् केन् यु अचीव् नथिङ्ग् नीदर् इन् दिस् वर्ल्ड् नार् इन् द वर्ल्ड् हियर् आफ्टर् इस् नान् सीयिङ्ग् अ ब्लैण्ड् पर्सन् केनाट् अचीव् एनिथिङ्ग् अब्रवीत् तु तस्यायतनं प्रतिष्ठां हवर् Did that Barkuhu, Barkuhu Varshnaha, did he tell you? What is Ayatana? What's the body of this Surya Devata? Pratishtham, what is the ultimate abode of that Surya Devata? Name Abraviditi, Janaka said, no, that he has not told me. Eka Vadvayeta Samraditi. Hey Samrad, then you have only been told about the one quarter of that Brahman. Savaino Bruhi Agnivalkya. Hey Agnivalkya, you, who thus knows the Brahman in its totality, may you please tell me. Chakshurevayatanam akasha pratishtha satyamityena dupasita. Hey Janaka, of this Surya Devata, this Chakshu, the faculty of seeing, so this instrument of seeing is the Ayatanam, that's the body. Akasha pratishtha, akasha means avyakrata, undifferentiated, antaryami. The inner controller, he is the pratishtha, he is the ultimate refuge about satyam iti enad upasita, and the secret name of this Brahman, the secret name of this Chakshur Brahman is satyam, the truth. And so, keeping the idea of the truth in the mind,
So uttering that name and keeping the idea of truth in mind, may you meditate upon this Brahman. Ka satyata yajnavalkya? He yajnavalkya, what is this truth? Chakshureva samrati dhovacha. Hey samrat, it is seeing. Chakshu here means the seeing is really truth. Chakshushave samrat pashyantam ahuhu adrakshihiti. People ask, so chakshushave vaipa samrat pashyantam. When so somebody sees by his own eyes, then, or he has seen it by his own eyes, when somebody asked him, adrakshihiti, hey, did you see it? Saha adrakshamiri. Then he says, yes, I saw it with my own eyes. So when seeing takes place with his own eyes, tat satyam bhavati, then that is definitely reliable. Here satyam means that is indeed reliable. Not so much when one gains that information through other means of knowledge, such as one hears, it is possible that it may not be quite accurate or quite reliable, but when one sees through one's eyes, with one's eyes, it is definitely reliable. Chakshurvai samrat paramam brahma. He samrat, this chakshu is indeed paramam brahma. Nayanam chakshur jahati. So one meditates like this, the chakshu never leaves him. Sarvaniyanam bhutana bhiksharanti. All the beings eagerly come to him, offering gifts. Deva bhutva devanapyati. Becoming the Aditya Devata here, he merges into the totality of all the devatas, meaning Hiranyagarbha. Eva vidvane dupaste. When one knows this and meditates in this manner. Hastrishivam sahasram dadami iti hovati janako vaideha. As usual, Janaka, the gratified and highly, highly pleased and gratified, offers him 1,000 cows with a elephant-like bull. Sahuvach yajnavalkya. But yajnavalkya again declined. Pitamya manyada nanushishyahare devi. But my father said that until the student or disciple is totally satisfied, that means he has gained what he should gain, until then you should not accept gifts from him. So page 949 says Bhashya. Yadevate kaschita barkuhu iti namataha krishnasya patyam varshnaha chakshurvai brahmeti adityo devata chakshushi upanishad satyam. So the trend is the same. Barkuhu iti namataha. The name of this acharya is Barku. Vrushnasya patyam, being son of Vrushna, he is called Varshnaha. So, Chakshurvai brahmedi. So, then Chakshuhu is Brahma. Here in this case, Aditya Devata. So, here Aditya Devata, who is the presiding deity of Chakshu, is to be meditated upon as Brahma. Chakshushi. Footnote 1. Chakshuradhikarane tadadhishtatra devata adityaha. Chakshushi means Chakshuradhikarane. In adhikarana location, namely Chakshu, the presiding deity is Aditya. And this is how one is to meditate. Then of course, that Aditya is a devata. That is the manifestation of Brahma. And where he manifests is his Chakshu. And the ultimate abode that controls everything is the Antaryami, the inner controller. Avashikai. Any roj yanu svabhav badlatvahe. Chakaravai. Upanishad satyam. Anu avad motto ka. Pela. Upanishad satyam. Footnote number 2. Aditya brahmanaha satyam idi upanishad. Of this Aditya brahma, the Upanishad, meaning the secret name, is Satyam. So, ka satyata yajnavalkya? Yajnavalkya, what is that satyata? What is that satya? Then yajnavalkya says, chakshureva samrati dhovacha. Hey, samrat, hey, emperor, this is chakshu, that seeing itself is truth or reliable here. Vashyakara explains here. Yasmat shrotrena shrutam anratam apesya
नदु चक्षुषा दृष्टम् तस्माद्वै सम्राट् पश्यन्तमाहुर्लोकाः अद्राक्षीस्त्वं हस्तिनमिते सचेदद्राक्षमिते इति आह तत्सत्यमेव भवति यस्तु अन्यो ब्रूयात् अहमश्रौषमिते तद्व्यभिचरति यत्तु चक्षुषा दृष्टं तदव्यभिचारित्वात् सत्यमेव भवति.
सो हौ कम सीइंग इज कॉल्ड ट्रूथ. अर्लियर आल्सो इन द अर्लियर उपासना आल्सो दिस केम. सो विथ द शाकल्य सो विरद्ध शाकल्य सो व्हेन दैट उपासना वाज गोइंग ऑन देयर आल्सो चक्षु वाज रेफर्ड टू सत्यम. यस्मात् श्रोत्रेण श्रुतम् अनुतमपि स्यात्. इट इज पॉसिबल दैट व्हेन वन इज नॉट सीन विथ वन्स ओन आईज and has heard from someone else, it is possible that that may not be truth, or it may not be right, it may not be right. Nadu chakshusha drishtam. But when one, idea is that when one hears, he hears this from someone else. And whether that someone else is telling him the truth or not cannot be definite. Whereas when one sees with one's own eyes, then it is one's own direct knowledge. Chakshusha drishtam. सो अनुतम स्याद अनुषंगः नदु चक्षुषा दुष्टम अनुतम स्याद. बट दैट विच वन हैज सीन विथ वन्स ओन आइज दैट सीइंग सो नॉलेज दैट वन हैज गेन बाय सीइंग कैन नॉट बी अनरिलायबल कैन नॉट बी रॉन्ग. तस्माद् वै सम्राट पश्यतमाहुः दैट्स व्हाई हे सम्राट हे एम्परर. सो व्हेन वन हैज सीन समथिंग आहु लोकाः द पीपल आस्क हिम अद्राक्षी त्वं हस्तिनमिति. हे डिड यू सी द एलिफेंट सचेत अद्राक्षमिति आह. इफ ही सेज यस आई सॉ इट तत् सत्यमेव भवति देन दैट बिकम्स डेफिनेटली रिलायबल ट्रूथफुल. यस तु अन्यो ब्रूयात् अहम् अश्रौषमिति अन्यः द्रष्टु भिन्नः. व्हेन समवन एल्स मे से हु इज नॉट सीन एंड ही सेज हे आई हर्ड दैट देयर इज एन एलिफेंट तद्व्यभिचरति. इट इज पॉसिबल दैट एलिफेंट मे नॉट बी देयर एंड ही मे हैव हर्ड अबाउट इट. इज पॉसिबल बट इट कैनॉट बी दैट एलिफेंट इज नॉट देयर व्हेन वन हैज सीन द एलिफेंट. सो एलिफेंट यू नो नॉट स्नेक एंड स्टफ लाइक दैट. सो परहैप्स वन स्नेक इज नॉट देयर एंड वन सीज द स्नेक वेयर इन फैक्ट देयर इज नो. बट एलिफेंट नोबडी कैन मिस्टेक नो. सो भाष्यकार इज व्हाट एलिफेंट हियर. सो हमश्रौषमिति तद्व्यभिचरति. इट इज पॉसिबल दैट इट इज यत् चक्षुषा दृष्टं तत् अव्यभिचारित्वात् सत्यमेव भवति. बट व्हाट वन हैज सीन विथ वन्स ओन आईज वन्स ओन आईज दैट बीइंग अव्यभिचारित्वात् दैट कैन नेवर बी फॉल्स. सो तत् सत्यमेव भवति. और दैट कैन नॉट बी अनफेथफुल. व्यभिचारी मीन्स एक्चुअली अनफेथफुल. एंड सो व्हाट वन हैज सीन दैट हैज टू बी फेथफुल और रिलायबल. So that cannot be unreliable because one has seen with one's own eyes. That's the reason why I say Yajnavalkya would tell, say to Maitreyi, Atma vani drashtavyah. Hey Maitreyi, Atma must be seen. Meaning that the knowledge of Atma must be as clear and as free from any doubts and error as the knowledge that one gains through perceiving by eyes. So that is always the clearest knowledge. You can never be sure about what something that you may have even touched and not seen. Tasted and not seen, smelled and not seen, and heard and not seen. But when something is seen, then it is the most reliable. Generally speaking, of course, it is not that eyes are the pramanam for everything. Then somewhere the smell becomes pramanam. So you may have seen the flower, but then it may not be the flower in that sense. But one thing is, of course, what you have seen is not flower, what you have seen is the form and color. That also you must know. We don't see flower, we see a form and color. And then with the memory that we have, the buddhi says this is flower. If buddhi has some other memory, that flower like this we had seen earlier was a false flower, then buddhi will say this is a false flower. So this kind of decision is made by the buddhi, that this is a flower, that this is a true flower or it is a false flower. All of these conclusions or decisions are made by the buddhi, not by the eyes. Eyes merely reveal the color and the form, that's all they are. But except that, it is always weird in that sense. And still, the nirnaya that buddhi makes out of what the eyes see, I guess it must be the most reliable, you know. That's what we are going to say here. Because the decision or the conclusion that you arrive at as far as the faculty of the touch is concerned, the faculty of touch alone is most reliable there. And as far as the words are concerned, it is not that, you know, the ears only reveal the words. Then buddhi has to decide whether it is true or not. So what we can say is that the decision that the buddhi comes to from the data that has been received by perception through eyes is the most reliable. The decision that buddhi may come to based on the data received from the other means of knowledge may not be that reliable, but this is the most reliable. In that sense we can say that chakshu is satyam. So truthfulness or reliability is always associated with seeing. So truth. Love is always associated with life. And intelligence always associated with speech. That is how the meditation. So intelligence that the Lord is manifest as speech, as fire and speech. And love that the Lord is manifest as life and the breath and the vayu. And the truth that the Lord is manifest as the sun and as the eyes and as the seeing. So this goes on in the same manner now, nothing much to comment upon. Going to the next passage, Ajipan humming Pavach, Ajipan Raya.
Yadevate kaschita bravir tachranava medhi abravin me gardhi vipitaha bharadvajah shrotram vai brahmedhi था मातृमान पितृमान आचार्यवान ब्रूयात् तथा तद्भारद्वाजो ब्रवीर श्रोत्रं वै ब्रह्मेति अश्रुण्मतो हि किं स्यादिति अब्रवीत्तुदे तस्यायतनम् प्रतिष्ठां नमे ब्रवीदिते एकपाद्वा एतत् सम्राडिते सवैनो ब्रूह्याग्निवल्क्य श्रोत्रमेवायतनम् आकाशः प्रतिष्ठा अनन्दैत्येनदुपासीत आनन्दतायाग्निवल्क्य दिश एव सम्राडिति होवाच तस्माद्वै सम्राट् अपि यां कां च दिशं गच्छति नैवास्या अन्तं गच्छति अनन्तता हि दिशः दिशो वै सम्राट् श्रोत्रम् श्रोत्रं वै सम्राट् परमं ब्रह्म नैनं श्रोत्रं जहाते सर्वाण्येनं भूतान्यभिक्षन्ते देवो भूत्वा देवानप्येते एवं विद्वानेतदुपास्ते हस्त्रशभं सहस्रं ददामीति होवाच जनको वैदेहः स होवाच याज्ञवल्क्यः पिता मे मन्यत नाननु शिष्य हरे देवे. So let us go to the Bhashya. Bhashyakara explains. Yadevate. This is the pratika also is becoming shorter and shorter, you know. So Yadevate, that's all. So Bhashyakara's pratika is becoming shorter. So Yadevate, Kasyada Bravitta Shunavavete. Hey Janaka, whatever Samacharya may have told you, please tell me. Abravin me Gardabhi Vipitaha Bharadvajaha. So name. Gardabhi Vipitaha and Bharadvajaha, he did indeed tell me, Shrotram Vai Brahmedi. Hey Yajnivalkya, he told me, or taught me rather, that Shrotra Here Shrotra is the faculty of hearing, means presiding deity, which is Dishaha, the quarters. So space, the quarters, so that is also a presiding, that's also a deity. So Dig Devata. And so that is Brahma. That's another aspect of the creation. So that's also another aspect of the let's say Vibhuti of the Lord. Then ultimately, the Yajnavalkya asks him, did he tell you about the Ayataram Pratishtha? Then says Janaka, no, he did not tell me. That means that he told you only the partial Brahma with only one leg, one foot or one quarter. So hey Yajnavalkya, please tell me the Brahman in its totality. Shrotra meva Ayataram Akasha Pratishtha. Shrotra, the ear. So that is that karanam, an instrument, so that is ayatanam. That is indeed the body of this Brahman of the nature of quarters of Dishaha. Akasha Pratishtha, as usual, the antaryam is the Pratishtha. The inner controller is the Pratishtha, the ultimate abode, refuge of everything, all of these. Anantaha ityenupasita. So what is the aspect of Lord that is manifest as quarters or directions? Anantaha, infinity. So infinity or boundlessness, you know. So boundlessness is the aspect of Lord that is manifest in this as quarters. So Ananka Anandata Yajnavalkya. Hey Yajnavalkya, what is this boundlessness? What is infinity? Dishaeva Samrat Dhovacha. Hey Samrat, this boundlessness in fact is the nature of these quarters themselves, Dishaya. Tasmadvi Samratvi Yam Kamtisham Gacchati. That's reason why, hey Samrat, whenever anyone goes in any direction, whether east or west, one never comes to the end of that direction. So directions are boundless because there is no end. You know, where does this east end? Where does the west end? No one can ever tell. In fact, no one can even tell where it begins. Anantatahi Dishaha. Therefore, hey Yajnavalkya, Dishaha, the quarters, that principle is Anantada, the boundlessness is manifest as a quarter, as a space. Disho Vai Samrat Shrotram. Say, hey Samrat, indeed, Dishaha, the quarters of the space, is Shrotram. This is an additional sentence here. Shrotram Vai Samrat Paramam Brahma. Hey Samrat, therefore, Shrotra, this ears or hearing is, or the presiding deity quarters, all of this, the quarters and the hearing, and the faculty of hearing, all of this is Paramam Brahma. Nainam Shrotram Jahati Sarvaniyanam Bhutana Vikshranti. The hearing never leaves him, that means always is faithful, is always with him. He is never deprived of the faculty of hearing, in short. Sarvaniyanam Bhutana Vikshranti, as we discussed yesterday. So all the beings, because he is meditating or identifying all principles, that is common to all the beings. So when he identifies the faculty of seeing, then also that is common to all the living beings. Hearing also is common to all the living beings. That is how he is identified with them all. And that's how he attains, gains a favor. That's why all the beings eagerly come to him. Or always favor him. Devo Bhutva Devanapyati. Becoming Devata, here he merges into Hiranyagarbha. Yeva Midvan is Upaste. So then the same dialogue takes place, the rest of it. Bhashyakara says, Gardabhi Vipitaiti Namataha Bharadvajaha Gotrataha Shrotram Vai Brahmeti. So, Gardabhi Vipitaha, that's an interesting name anyway, but that's the name of this Acharya. Bharadvaja. So one who is in the Gotra of Bharadvaja is called Bharadvaja Gotrataha. Not son of Bharadvaja, but one belonging to the Gotra of Bharadvaja. Bharadvaja. Shrotram Vai Brahmeti. That is what he taught. Shrotram is indeed Brahma. Okay, then. Says footnote number 2 there. Shrotradhikarana. Tadabhimanini Digdevada Shrotramiti Uchyate. Shrotradhikarana, in the location that is Shrotra, the presiding deity, that is the Dik or the quarter, that is Brahma here, that is to be meditated upon Brahma. So Devata is to be meditated upon as Brahma. Vashyakara continues.
श्रोत्रे दिग्देवता अनन्तः इति एनुपासीत. सो हे हे किंग हे जनक मे यू मेडिटेट अपॉन दिस एज अनंत एज इन्फिनिटी बाउंडलेसनेस. का अनंतता श्रोत्रस्य. What is this boundlessness or infinity as associated with Shrotra, as associated with hearing? Purvat bheda bheda abhipraya prashna. Idea is that, is it the same as Shrotram or is it different from Shrotram? Or is it the same as the Digdevata or different from Digdevata, the quarters, not even Digdevata but the quarters. Just as the body of this Digdevata is different, that is the faculty of hearing, the Pratishtha is also different, that is Antaryami. Similarly also, is this different? The Anandata, is it different from the Digdevata or the same? Then it is identical to that. So what is Digdevata? Nothing but the principle of boundlessness. So what is Surya? Nothing but the principle of seeing, principle of light or principle of seeing. What is Vayu? Nothing but principle of life. And similarly, what is Agni? Nothing but the intelligence. So Ananta hetena upasita. Hey Agnivalkya, we have meditated upon this as Ananta, as infinite or boundless. And ka Ananta Shrotrasya, what is this boundlessness associated with Shrotra, with hearing? Then says, Dishah eva Shrotrasya Anantyam Yasmat Tasmat Vai Samrat प्राचीम उदीचीम वा याम कांचर विदिशं गच्छते नैव अस्याः अंतं गच्छते कश्चिदपि. अतः अनंतता हि दिशः दिशो वै सम्राट श्रोत्रम् तस्मात् दिगानन्त्यमेव श्रोत्रस्य आनन्त्यम्. सो का अनन्तदा श्रोत्रस्य. व्हाट इज द इन्फिनिटी और बाउंडलेसनेस ऑफ श्रोत्र ऑफ द हियरिंग. दिश एव श्रोत्रस्य आनन्त्यम्. हे सम्राट, this dishah, the quarters of the directions themselves, are this anantyam, the boundlessness associated with hearing. Yasmat tasmat vasamrat, since these quarters or directions are infinite or boundless, that's the reason why samrat prachim udichim vayam kanjita vidisham gacchade. Whenever one goes either in the east direction or in the north direction or in the direction yam kanjita vidisham gacchade, in whichever direction one goes, Nivasyaha antam bhavati gacchati kaschidapi. No one is ever able to go or reach the end of this direction or end of a quarter. No one can. In fact, no one can tell where it begins also. Not only that, the end of the east or the north direction is not there. No one even can tell where the beginning is. The beginning is only with oneself. So, the beginning of a direction or a quarter is only with oneself. So, where is east? Only with reference to myself, I say where east is. When you are there, the east may be different for you and the west may be. For me, what is east may become the east for you, but what is west for me also may become east for you. And so forth. So, this is purely, with reference to one's own self. No doubt, there is east. Where the sun rises is called east, that is fine. But still, what is east and west, whether the western countries are western for us, they can be eastern for some other people. And the country in the south can be north for someone else. And so any given thing can be north, south, east, west, depending on only reference point. So one cannot tell where the beginning is, because had the beginning been there, then the end would have been there. But there is no end of these directions, nor is there a beginning. They are boundless. So the principle of boundlessness is manifest in the directions of the quarters. Atah anantatahi dishah. Therefore, the directions are anantata, are boundlessness. Dishoi Samrat Shrotram. Hey Samrat, this Dishah, the quarters themselves, are Shrotram or the hearing. See footnote number 1 there, Dishoi the Kathameda. So where did you get this?
we understand that Shrotram, the faculty of hearing, is the modification of the element Akasha. As you know, the five faculties of perception that we have, each one is the modification or product of the sattva aspect of the respective element. And similarly then, the faculty of hearing is the manifestation of the sattva aspect of element Akasha, space. Why do you say quarters or directions? Shrunu, Akasham eva tattat pradesh sambandham sambandham sat tattat digakhyam labhate. So what is east and what is west and what is north? Nothing but the space. So space associated with that particular region or that particular place is called direction. So what we call quarters or directions are not something that is independent of space. Space alone comes to be called north, south, east, west as associated with a particular place or region. Tadatirikta diksambhave pramana bhavat. We do not see any dik or the direction as different from the space. Ataha nakachit anupattihi. So even though it should have been said that disho vai samrat, akasham vai samrat, that's what should have been said. Brahma shrotramiti. It is akasha that is shrotram, but it's quite alright because akasha alone comes to be called by different quarters of disha, and therefore this is okay. Nakachit anupattihi tyartha. There is nothing untenable in this. Disho vai samrat shrotram, tasmat dik anantyameva shrotrasya anantyam. Therefore, tasmat dishameva shrotratvat. Because its quarters themselves are shrotra or hearing, that's the reason why the boundlessness of the quarters is the boundlessness of the ears. You know, because the ears and the space are not different in that sense. So what the ears can hear also is boundless. That's the reason why when you hear something, as Arjuna says, you know, that I am not satisfied by listening to your nectar-like words, you know. And so, again and again tell me. So this is how they say. So ears are the mouth with which he is drinking the nectar. Of course, when the nectar goes into the stomach, then there is a limit to what you can drink. But here, when you drink through the ears, because what is the stomach of the ear? Nothing but space. That's the reason why one can never be satisfied, you know, by listening to the nectar. Even by drinking of the nectar, one will get satisfied or one will get filled up. But one can never get filled up by listening to the nectar. Anyway, so this is another glory of the Lord. That is the boundlessness. The next one. Same page, 952.
Yadevate kaschita bravir tachranava mede अब्रवीन में सत्यकामो जावाल है मनोवै ब्रह्मेरे तथा मात्रमान पितृमान आचार्यवान ब्रूया तथा तज्जावालो ब्रवीर मनोवै ब्रह्मेरे अमनसो हि किं स्यादिते अब्रवीत्तुते तस्यायतनं प्रतिष्ठा नमे ब्रवीदिते एकपाद्वा एतत् सम्राडिते सवैनो ब्रूह्याग्निमल्क्य मन एवायतनं आकाशः प्रतिष्ठा आनंदेत्येनुपासीत कानन्दतायाग्निवल्क्य मन एव सम्राडिति होवाच मनसा वै सम्राट् स्त्रियमभिहार्यते तस्यां प्रतिरूपः पुत्रो जायते स आनन्दः मनो वै सम्राट् परमं ब्रह्म नैनं मनो जहाते सर्वाण्येनं भूतान्यभिक्षरन्ते Devo Bhutva Devanapyete. Evam Vidvane Tadupaste. Sastrishabham Sahasram Dadamete. Hovacha Janako Vaideha. Sahovacha Yajnavalkya. Kitame Manyate. Nananu Shishya Harete.
So now Satyakama Javalha.
So he told me, Mano Vai Brahmede, that mind is Brahma. Yatha Matruvan, same compliments are given, even though Java Satyakam did not have father, as best as we know, you know. Anyway, still, he of course had the same authority. He had father, of course, but then it was not known. He didn't have the benefit of the education from the father. He had the benefit from the education from mother and acharya. But he displayed that same culture and the same purity. So when he goes to the teacher and the teacher asks him, what is a gotra? And the fellow did not know. So I don't know. He comes and asks his mother, and mother says, I also don't know what your gotra is. He just goes and repeats that before the teacher. That shows his purity. That means that he had the purity which he would have had he had the education from the father also. That way, of course, he had the requisite and much greater purity. And so, yatha matruvan pitruvan acharyavan bruyat tatha tad javala abravid. So what Javala said is indeed is reliable. That means he is pram. So pramanam manovai brahmedi amanaso hikim syat. Everywhere this is said. What can a person who does not hear, what can he achieve? Or even one doesn't have a mind, what can one achieve? Idea is that when one doesn't have this, that means one has not done the upasana in somewhere. Either there is an abuse of this hearing or seeing or whatever it is. That's the reason why one is born without that faculty here. And that's the reason why his pursuit in life is highly impaired. There are cases, of course, when blind people also have achieved great things, and then even deaf people or the mute and so on. And still, people with the same talent, had they not been blind, you know, What could they have achieved? And so that shows that there is a certain amount of deprivation here. And that's why one who is deprived of the mind, what can that person achieve? One is deprived of hearing, what can he achieve? He is deprived of certain chunk of life, you know. The whole world of sounds, the whole world of infinity is described, or he is deprived of. When one cannot see, one is deprived of the whole world of light. And so also when one doesn't have mind, which means that one doesn't have a developed mind, then one is deprived of the whole world of thinking, you know, and knowing that one can otherwise have. Amanaso hi kim syaditi. It is true. What Satyakama Javala says, that mind is Brahman, is indeed true. Because what can one without a mind achieve? So what can he get? Nothing. Abravitu deitasya ayatanam pratishtham. However, did he tell you about the ayatana and the pratishtha of this deity? Residing deity of the mind is Chandrama. So did he tell you about the abode, the body as well as the abode of that? Name abravijiti heyagnyavakya. He did not tell me that. Ekapadvayeta samrat vidhan. Hey samrat, this is Brahman, only incomplete Brahman. Savayino bruhiyagnyavakya. Heyagnyavakya, you who know the Brahman in totality, you please tell me. Mana eva ayatanam akasha pratishtha. So of that presiding deity that is Chandramaha, the manaha, mind is the body, and as usual, the antaryama is the pratishtha. Anandaha iti ena upasita. So it is mind with which one experiences ananda. The idea is that, where is ananda experience? In the mind. And ananda here, generally speaking, often they mean ananda means the ananda that comes only from the association, you know, of a man and woman. So from that union, the ananda that comes, that is often referred to as ananda, as is the case here also. I mean, that is what they call bliss, or that is the most intense the experience of ananda that one can have as far as the physical experience is concerned. So ka ananda ta yajnavalkya. What do you mean by ananda that is associated with the mind? So how is mind ananda? Or is the same as the mind, or is it different from the mind? Manaeva samrat iti hovacha. Hey samrat, it is mind that is ananda. Manasave samrat striyam abhihariyate.
So one thus unites with these three, or one courts the woman also, one courts a woman with the mind, woos a woman, fences a woman with the mind. Tasyam pratirupah putro jayate, ultimately the son of the same nature, one's own self is born, sahananda, and that is a great joy. So ultimately in the Vedic culture, I guess ananda comes from the son, you know. Atmavai putro, atmavai nama putra, so putrovai, what is it? Atmave putra namase, that's all. So putra is my own self, you know. Amazing. So when one sees the son, everywhere they give the example of the son, you know, for the father, not even for the mother. So actually they tell us that the girls or the daughters have, you know, rather more intimacy with the father, and the sons have more intimacy with mother. So it is said, you know, if it is there, then the trend is like this. But somehow in the Vedic culture, always here, Atmavai Putra Namasi. Hey Putra, Atmavai. So this is nothing, you are nothing but myself. Or what is called Putra is nothing but myself. And so one looks upon Putra as one's own self. And so how much Ananda one's own self will give, that is what Putra gives. So how that Putra is possible? Only through the mind. So how the whole process began and culminated into having a son, so that is how the Putra is Ananda. Anyway, Manoho is Samrat, Paramam, Ananda is the Brahma is the. And so, mind is the Ananda. So, mind is the Parambrahma. Nainam Manodihadi. Thus, so meditating upon the principle called Ananda. So that Ananda is again the vibhuti of the Lord. Ultimately, any kind of a pleasure is experienced through the mind. The pleasure is experienced through the sense organ, no doubt, but it's the mind that feels it, you know. And so, the mind ultimately is the instrument. So when the mind becomes clear, that's when one experiences Ananda. And so that way, of course, the Ananda that Brahman is. See, here Ananda is understood as this can be experienced, the mind is not there. Of course, there is no creature who doesn't have the mind. Here where the mind is man, the mind is not developed. Then also one is deprived of the Ananda that the life has to give. This is not the only Ananda. I mean, Ananda is of different levels here. One can gain Ananda of the life by many things, you know, by intellectual pursuits, by the pursuit of the art, you know, all of that is tremendously joyful. And all of the Ananda one can have when one has a cultured or developed mind. To be able to enjoy music, to be able to enjoy literature, to be able to enjoy poetry or art or whatever it is. Of course, Vedanta. It one requires a mind, and not only a mind, but a refined mind. So, when the refinement is not there in the mind, that's what we'll say that one doesn't have a mind, a mindless fellow. Doesn't mean that he doesn't have a mind, but he's not a thinking person, you know. Or he's not a thinking person, or doesn't have any sense at all, you know. Common sense is not there, whatever. So, when he is not there, one is deprived of the ananda of life. So, one experiences ananda that Brahman is through the mind. One experiences the boundlessness that Brahman is through the ears. One experiences light that Brahman is through the eyes. One experiences the intelligence that Brahman is through the speech. So this is how one experiences Brahman all the time. It's not that Brahman, that is Saguna Brahma, is not an object of experience. It is being experienced by us all the time through the faculties, because everything is Brahman. But the ananda that Brahman is, one would be deprived of. That's why it was said. So one who doesn't have the mind will be deprived of that experience of ananda. And that is how, what one can attain in the life. And so the ananda that Brahman is experienced by mind here. So that is how, that's why we say that the ananda and mind are not different. It is with the mind that one experiences ananda, therefore the ananda and mind are not different. Or it is the boundlessness that one experiences, it is through the ears that one experiences, therefore they are not different. That's how the principle of boundlessness was identified with Shrotram, or the truthfulness identified with the eyes, or Ananda with the mind. Sarvanayanam bhutana viksharanti. Again, since he's identifying with that universal principle, of course Brahman is universal, but its glories are also universal, manifest in all the creatures. And since identifying with that, Sarvanayanam bhutana viksharanti, all the creatures become favorable to him, eagerly come to him. Deva bhutva devanapyadi. Ultimately, he becomes an ananda. He becomes Brahman of the nature of ananda. or Chandrama in this case, of course, the Chandrama also is Alladaka, is always pleasant, is pleasing. So pleasing is the nature of Chandrama. That is also Ananda. Chandrama represents Ananda. Satchidananda. So Lord Shiva has three eyes, the sun and the moon are the fire. Of that, the moon represents the Ananda. The Sat, the Chit, or the knowledge is represented by the sun. And the fire represents the Sat, because fire is responsible for the life also. So fire digests or cooks the food, and that's how responsible for sustaining the life. So you can say that is Sat, and the sun illumines and removes the darkness. So knowledge or Chit, and the moon always gives you Allah, the pleasant pleasure, therefore associated with Ananda. So that also the moon and the mind, of course, are associated and associated also with Allah, the pleasure. So one meditates on that and he becomes that. Deva Bhutva Devanapyati. And ultimately, through that upasana, he becomes one with God, Saguna Brahma. Deva Vidvan Etupaste. So knowing this, when someone meditates, this is what one becomes. Same way, Janaka made an offer and Yajnavalkya declined to receive that gift from Janaka. Says Vashyakara, Satyakamaiti. Yadeva also is gone, you know. So now, from that pratika also is not necessary. So Satyakamaiti. Namatah Javalayah Patyam Javalah. So he is now identified with the mother's name, Javalayah Patyam. So he is known as Javala because son of Javala. That is not known by his father's name. So this is one sage, outstanding sage, known by his mother, you know. So that shows how outstanding the mother must have been. You are always known to the outstanding one in the family. That's why people always change their surnames, you know. They change their surname to Lal Bhai or Kastur Bhai or Sara Bhai or something like that, you know. Because they won't be known by their names, whatever it is, you know. The idea is that when there is some, that is how Bharadvaja, this person is a, so is known through the sage Bharadvaja. So I come from a family of whom Bharadvaja was the head, you know, of this the whole lineage. So one is proud to identify oneself with the distinguished person in the family. My great grandfather was such and such. Swami, my grandfather was a disciple of Swami Tapovanam, you know. Whatever. So that is how one gets proud, you know. So identifying with the father or grandfather or whatever, or maternal grandfather sometimes, paternal grandfather. Here with mother. So Javalaya Patyam Javalaha. Then Mahashikara continues, Chandrama Manasi Devata. So footnote number 3 says, Manasi Adhikarane Tadabhimani Chandra Devata Atra Mano Brahma. And so, mind is Adhikaranam, obtaining where is the Chandrama, the Devata, Chandrama Sachandrama, Chandrama Devata. And so, that is to be meditated upon as Brahma. So Chandrama is nothing but the embodiment of Ananda. So we can say Chandrama is nothing but the embodiment of Ananda. The sun is nothing but the embodiment of light or truth in this case. Fire is nothing but the embodiment of intelligence, and Dishaha quarters nothing but the embodiment of the boundlessness. So here Chandrama is the embodiment of Ananda. Ananda that the Lord is manifest as Chandrama. So Ananda that the Lord is took a form as Chandrama. And so since Ananda is all associated with Chandrama, therefore one can meditate upon Brahman. Yes, Chandrama is Ananda. Chandrama Manasi Devata. Then Ananda Ityupanishad Yasmat Mana Eva Ananda Tasmat Manasavai Samrat Triyam Abhikamaya Manaha Abhiharyate Prarthayate Ityarthah Tasmat Yam Striyam Abhikamaya Manaha Abhiharyate Tasyam Pratirupah Anurupah Putro Jayate Sa Anandahetuh Putrah येन मनसा निर्वर्त्यते तन्मनः आनन्दः आनन्द इति मनोब्रह्मणः उपनिषद आनन्द इज सीक्रेट नेम ऑफ दिस ब्रह्मन विच मैनिफेस्ट इज माइंड यस्माद् मनः एव आनन्दः बिकॉज द माइंड इज आनंद इन फैक्ट देयर इज नो आनंद विदाउट माइंड दैट्स एंड इट इज सेड माइंड इज आनंद तस्माद् मनसा वै सम्राट् स्त्रियम् अभिकामयमानः अभिहार्यते सो व्हेन पर्सन डिजायर्स अ वुमन देन अभिहार्यते प्रार्थयते इत्यर्थः फुटनोट वसु अस्य स्थाने प्राप्यति पाठ साधियान प्रतिभाते प्रार्थयते और प्राप्यते तस्माद् याम स्त्रियम् अभिकामयमानः अभिहार्यते तस्याम् प्रतिरूपः अनुरूपः पुत्रो जायते सो देयरफॉर द सन ऑफ हिज ओन काइंड इज बॉर्न स आनंद हेतुः एंड I guess father sees the reflection of himself in the sun. That is how. So that is how that gives him further ananda. Because parents always ask, you know, whose child are you? You know, whose son are you? And things like that, you know. So there also competition goes on sometimes, you know. I mean, this is between mother and father also sometimes competition goes on. So it depends on the child is, identified with what? I'm mother's child. I'm mom's child. Then father feels hurt. I'm dad's child, mother feels hurt. Indeed it happens, you know. Because everybody wants, you know, this is my child, all that it should be identified with me. And when it doesn't happen, then they also try. They also manipulate that way. And so mother everybody always does that, you know. So whenever you want somebody's favor or want, you know, that they should be identified, you always please them by giving them, you know. So mother always fulfills all the desires of the child, you know. So particularly when the father is somewhat strict, mother finds it very convenient. She will do everything that the child wants, you know. And the child feels that my mother is great, you know. There is no one like that. In fact, the mother may have spoiled the child, you know. So this fellow may have been a brat, whatever it is. So, but then the child may have been spoiled. However, the child grows with the idea that mother is very loving. Mother could very well be loving. Not that she is not, but the idea is that, and it's not that that one may really do it just by one's nature also. But sometimes this can be done deliberately also, you know, in order to gain the favor of the child and gain the identification of the child. I don't know, this is my imagination, you know, that this, because where human being is, politics is always, by politics I mean, you are trying to accomplish your own end, you have an agenda, human being always has an agenda, that's what is meant by politics. Politics means having an agenda of your own, that's all. And so to fulfill the agenda, you will manipulate and maneuver and do anything, you know. Not that it is done only at the top level, you know, by the Congress president or whoever it is, you know. He'll try to manipulate his own party and try to bring people into his fold. But every human being wants to do that. In his own way or in her own way, there is a need on the part of the human being to do that. To bring people to their own fold, to form its own support group, you know. So that you feel secure. There is a need for an acceptance. And when you find somebody loves you, then there is a great sense of fulfillment because you feel at least you discover that you are lovable. That means that there is an acceptance of somebody accepted you. And then at least you see yourself somewhat acceptable. Other people have a lot of problems, you know. Many people don't know get married and things like that. They also have these problems, you know. Tremendous sense of non-acceptance. Nobody can, they can't believe that somebody can love, you know. And so when somebody does it indeed, I tell go ahead, you know, because somebody asked me. Because it's the first time that the person has felt being loved, really. So either from the parents or whatever it is, some people feel deprived of love in their life, even as they grow. So they feel that the parent is a middle child, a third child, or whatever it is. I mean, what kind of syndromes are maybe, I do not know. But anyway, person feels, you know, that he is or she is not loved. Either the parents were too busy. Basically, parents are too busy. When they are young, they don't have time for children, you know. And children are always so demanding that there is a limit to what the, and particularly father, he doesn't have time. He's too busy. And so, and children's demand are infinite. That being the case, usually it happens that the father, you know, so child doesn't receive as much love from the father as whatever it is. And only when that person becomes grandfather, then he discovers what being father is really. Until then, the fellow doesn't. So you'll find that the children of this person, they don't think much of this person. But the grandchildren think very highly of him, you know. Grandchildren think very highly of him. Because now he knows what a child, what, now he has some time. And now also he has become mature. So some of the sensitivity has developed in him, you know, which he had not developed when he was father. Then he didn't have the, what is this child? He doesn't know how to relate to the child also perhaps. Mother can relate because of course it is her own thing, you know, her own part. But the father may not want to relate to the child always, you know. And so he is too busy with his other activities and other agendas. But then those agendas are over. When he becomes old, now when the grandchild comes, that grandchild's father doesn't have time, you know. And now the grandchild is seeking someone whom who can love him, and the grandfather. You can see this grandfather, then it's really a special entity. Children always go to grandfather. Nobody else can go to their grandfather also in the family, by the way. Sometimes, you know. Sometimes, not always, but sometimes you can say, you know, nobody else can go to him. But the child always spends time with grandfather. You are surprised, you know. This person otherwise is so difficult to deal with, you know, or relate to. But somehow grandchild has always invoked that corner. The grandchild manages to invoke that corner from the grandfather. And they are able to relate to. Each one has found an acceptance, really. Even grandfather hasn't found, in his life, he hasn't found an acceptance. That's the problem, you know. The reason why he is not able to love is because he has not found that he is loved. A person who is able to, who can love? The person who has received love. In the course of our upbringing, if he received the love, it's then, and we have received trust. Love requires trust, of course. And you can't trust because you have not been trusted. And so people cannot trust this. So not being able to trust is a big problem people have, you know. Because I don't think that I have been trusted. And so, or my trust may have been violated. That also is. As a child grows, and you find that the mother is not what he thought it to be. And father is not what he thought it to be. So whatever reason, nobody is what they think to be anyway. Because the child thinks that they should be gods and no parents are gods. But still, sometimes parents will be less than what they should be, you know, in the sense that not being able to fulfill even the basic needs of the child. And not reliable, not trustworthy. All the time violating the trust of the child. Manipulating the child, that may happen. And so the child cannot trust. And when the trust is violated from the parents, it is so difficult to trust anybody else. And if your brother, sister also happen to be like that, or a couple of friends have done that to you, or people have done it to you, you know. Some people are so unlucky, very often, you know, that again and again that happens. The trust is violated. Becomes so difficult to trust anybody. And that grandchild and grandfather also has grown like that, you know. Now here is a grandchild who completely accepts him, as is. You see, more than grandmothers, you know, grandfathers in particular, I've seen. So grandfather finds a complete acceptance here. No rejection from this child. And so as the person is, the child accepts. And that's the reason why a child also finds naturally, the child has invoked that from this person. The mutual trust. And child is able to trust this person completely, and grandfather will trust the child also completely. That trust breeds love. There cannot be love without trust. Both of them go together. But anyway, this is how. It is not so much that you see the son and become happy, but see the grandson and really become happy. And very often grandsons look like grandfathers also. I do not know. Very often it may happen that way also. But whatever. And so, putro jayate sa ananda hetuhu putra. That putra is ananda hetuhu. Is a cause of great joy and satisfaction and fulfillment. Sena manasa nirvartyate, ultimate nishpadyate. The mind by which this has ultimately been accomplished. Tan manaha anandaha. He samrat, that mind is ananda. So may you meditate. So ananda that the Lord is has now become manifest as the mind, as Chandrama in the level of totality, and as the mind at the level of individuality. So everywhere there is an connection here between Adhyatma, Adhibhuta and Adhidaiva here. Adhyatma and Adhidaiva and Adhibhuta also. So the Ayatram, of course, is instrument, so instrument associated with a given element, you can see that connection here also. Okay. Tathapi katham anandatvam manasa sambhavati ukta vidya putrasya anandatvevi. Even if putra is ananda, how is the mind ananda? Because ultimately mind is the instrument, or mind is the faculty with which this has been accomplished. Okay. Finally then,
Yadevate kasyada braveed. Tatshranava meti. Abraveen me vidagdha shakalya. Hrudayam vai brahmeti. Yatha matruvan pitruvan acharyavan bruyat. Tathachakalyo braveed. Hrudayam vai brahmeti. Arudayasya kim syadit. Arudayasya hi kim syadite. Abravitu de tasyayatanam. Pradishtham. Name braveedite. Ekapadva etat samradite. Savaino bruhiyagnivalkya. Hrudayamevayatanam. Akasha pratishtha. Chitrityena dupasita. Kaschitta yagna valkya. Hrudayameva samradhi hovacha. Hrudayam vai samrat sarvesham bhutanam ayatanam. Hrudayam vai samrat sarvesham bhutanam pratishtha. Hrudaye hyeva samrat sarvani bhutani pratishthitani bhavante. Hrudayam vai samrat paramam brahma. Nainam hrudayam jahate. Sarvanyenam bhutanyabhiksharante. Devo bhutva devanapyete. Evam vidvanetadupaste. Hastrishabham sahasram dadamete. Hovacha janako vaideha. Sahovacha yagnivalkyaha. Pitame manyate. Nananu shishya hare dede. Yadevate kaschidabraveed tachrunvameti. Hey Janaka, please let me hear whatever Samadhar Acharya may have told you. Abraveen me vidagdha shakalya. Acharya shakalya vidagdha. Same one, you know. Whose head had fallen down, same vidagdha shakalya. Yes, he did tell me. Hrudayam vai brahmeti. What did he tell you? Hrudayam vai brahmeti. The heart is Brahman. So heart is also the faculty. Now here you have to imagine heart with the faculty of projection. So mind is the faculty of knowing and heart is the faculty of projecting or the faculty of creating. So it is the projecting faculty with which one actually sees the dream, you know. And so faculty of the creation or the sankalpa, all of that projection, all of that takes place by at the level of heart. Mind is where the thinking and knowing takes place. And heart where the feeling and projection takes place. So here that heart also will have to be understood as nothing but that faculty of creation or projection. Hrudayam vai brahmeti. Yatha matruvan pitruvan acharyavan bruyat. So again shakalya also has been complimented here as the acharya whose words should be depended upon. Abravet hrudayam vai brahmeti. When Shakalya told you that Hrudayam Brahma, it is quite right. Ahrudayasthi hi kim syadidi. When one cannot create, when one cannot project, so what can one accomplish? Nothing can one accomplish with it. Abravitu de tasyayatanam pratishtham. However, did he tell you about the body and the pratishtha? Name abravidati. Did not tell me. He kavadva etas samraditi. He samrat. There is only the 1/4 of Brahman. Savai no bruhi agnivalkya. He agnivalkya, you who knows the Brahman in its entirety, you please tell me. Tell me, teach me. Hrudayam eva ayatanam. Footnote number 1. Hrudayam adhyatmikam antahkaranam. Tadashraya vapuravayava palamityapyahuhu.
హృదయం ఆధ్యాత్మికం అంతఃకరణం. తర్వాత అంతఃకరణం మీరుకోవాలి హృదయం. అండ్ తదాశ్రయ వపురవయవ అండ్ వేద అంతఃకరణం హ్యాడ్ ఇట్ సీట్ దట్ ఈస్ ది వపురవయ దట్ లింబ్ ఆఫ్ ద బాడీ. ఫలం, ఫలం మీన్స్ ఫ్లాష్. సో దట్ దట్ లంప్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లాష్ యునో విచ్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ హృదయం. సో బోత్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ హృదయం. హృదయం ఆధ్యాత్మిక అంతఃకరణం. సో బై హృదయ వి అండర్స్టాండ్ ది అంతఃకరణం అసోసియేటెడ్ విత్ వన్ సెల్ఫ్, ఆర్ బై హృదయ ఆల్సో వి అండర్స్టాండ్ దట్ ఫ్లాష్ యునో. సో ద లంప్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లాష్ ఆల్సో విచ్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ హార్ట్. బోత్. సో హృదయం ఏవ ఆయతనం ఆకాశ ప్రతిష్ట. సో హృదయం యు కెన్ సే అంతఃకరణం ఆర్ దిస్ లంప్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లాష్ కెన్ బి కాల్డ్ ది ఆయతనం. సో దట్ ఇస్ ద బాడీ. ఆకాశ ప్రతిష్ట యాజ్ యూజువల్ ది అంతర్యామి ది ఇన్నర్ కంట్రోలర్ ఇస్ ప్రతిష్ట. స్థితి ఇది ఏం ఉపాసీత స్టెబిలిటీ సపోర్టింగ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. సో హియర్ హార్ట్ ఇస్ ద స్థితి ది సపోర్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. కా స్థితదా యాజ్ఞవల్క్య హీ వాట్ ఇస్ ది స్టెబిలిటీ యాజ్ఞవల్క్య. హృదయం ఏవ సమ్రాడి హోవాచ ఇట్ ఇస్ హార్ట్ అగైన్ వై హార్ట్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ దట్ ద హోల్ ఐడియా ఆఫ్ క్రియేటింగ్ అండ్ ప్రొజెక్టింగ్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ది స్టెబిలిటీ. హృదయం వై సమ్రాట్ సర్వేషాం భూతానాం ఆయతనం. ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ అగైన్ కమ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ది శాకల్య బ్రాహ్మణ అగైన్. సో హృదయం వై సమ్రాట్ సర్వేషాం భూతానాం ఆయతనం. సో వి వర్ టోల్డ్ హే యాజ్ఞవల్క్య హూ ఆర్ యూ హెస్ ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ ది ఈస్టర్న్ క్వార్టర్ ఐఎమ్ ది ఆదిత్య. సో వేర్ ఇస్ ఆదిత్య హ్యాస్ ఇట్స్ ప్రతిష్ట ఇన్ ది ఐస్ అండ్ వేర్ ఇస్ ది ఐస్ ఆఫ్ ది ప్రతిష్ట ఇన్ ద హృదయం. దిస్ ఇస్ హౌ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ వాజ్ సెయిడ్ టు బి అల్టిమేట్లీ రిజాల్వ్డ్ ఇన్ ద హార్ట్. ఎర్లియర్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ వాజ్ ప్రొజెక్టెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది హార్ట్ అండ్ హియర్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ అల్టిమేట్లీ రిజాల్వ్డ్ ఇన్ టు హార్ట్. సో హోల్ శాకల్య బ్రాహ్మణ టోల్డ్ అస్ హృదయం వై సర్వాట్ సర్వే సమ్రాట్ సర్వేషాం భూతానాం ఆయతనం. హృదయం వై సమ్రాట్ సర్వేషాం భూతానాం ప్రతిష్ట. హృదయ హే సర్వా హేవ సమ్రాట్ సర్వాణి భూతాన్ని ప్రతిష్ఠితాన్ని భవంతి. బికాస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఫ్రమ్ ది హార్ట్ ది అంతఃకరణం. అగైన్ హార్ట్ ఆల్సో బికాస్ అంతఃకరణ ఇస్ సీట్ ఇన్ దిస్ హార్ట్. సో ఫిజికల్ హార్ట్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ఫ్రమ్ వేర్ ఆల్ ది బీయింగ్స్ ఆర్ ప్రొజెక్టెడ్ బై విచ్ ఆల్ ది బీయింగ్స్ ఆర్ సస్టైన్ అండ్ టు విచ్ ఆల్ ది బీయింగ్స్ గో బ్యాక్. హృదయం వై సమ్రాట్ పరమం బ్రహ్మ. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద క్రియేషన్ యూనో ద ప్రొజెక్షన్. సో దిస్ అనదర్ గ్లోరీ ఆఫ్ ద లార్డ్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ది creation of projection of the glory of the Lord. And so that itself is manifest as a heart here. So this heart is a very important limb, the most important limb. In fact, my research has shown that heart is a much more greater energy than even the brain. So far they think that it is brain from where all the intelligence is, and from where all the intelligence is in fact created in the form through the chemical processes. The consciousness and intelligence actually is created from the brain. And so by way of the neurons, you know, so neurons are they emanate from the brain. Of course now they say that every cell has that intelligence, but that too the heart, that is where there is a 10 times more energy than the brain has. It is no accident, you know, that the yogis always prescribe the meditation with the concentration on heart. So I recently came across a book. I just read it briefly. One of the Indians in California, one Dr. Bhatt, you know, he is from Karnataka, and he has written a book. And then how cancer and how heart disease and cancer are the greatest killers right now, and how they all happen only because of the process of thinking. This is there, you know, and how therefore by reversing the whole process of thinking that one can actually bring about a remission, you know, in any disease. Why only these? But these are the examples. And so the process of reversion of our thinking, reversal of the trend of thinking, is through the heart. That in you focus, concentrate your attention on the heart and deliberately entertain the positive thoughts, deliberately entertain the thought of blessing, of compassion, of kindness, you know, deliberately do that. And that is how this, because the thinking originates from there, because the intelligence is concentrated there, there was thinking originates from there. So there itself we bring about the change of intelligence. You see, if every cell has intelligence, the heart is the most intelligence there. So it is a basic intelligence that is responsible for all patterns of thinking. So when a person thinks, The person thinks only in a certain pattern because that pattern is inbuilt. That's the reason why I respond to a situation in a certain way, depending upon the inbuilt pattern. You know, they call it vasanas or trends or tendencies, whatever they call. So whether it is called vasana or tendencies or samskaras, where I respond without thinking, just what we call spontaneously or impulsively I respond, that means there is a built-in intelligence in there, which actually prompts me to respond in a certain way. If you bring about a transformation, that intelligence, understand? So, because there is an intelligence associated with my personality, with my body, with my heart, with my being actually. And that is how I conduct, I behave the way I do, I think the way I do, I respond the way I do. And that's why I am what I am. I am nothing but the intelligence, built-in intelligence that I am. Ultimate intelligence is Brahman. But that intelligence manifests as his DNA, you know, in this body. And that is why a particular kind of personality in the body and the mind are there. And that intelligence, let us say, the most concentration is in the heart. That is why if you bring about a transformation of a whole thinking process at the level of heart, you can bring about a transformation in your own personality. So you prakriti and prana go together, they don't go together. This prakriti, so prakriti can never change, it has to change. In fact, that is what is the purusharth of a human being, is to completely transform prakriti. That's the greatest siddhi. What we call antahakarana siddhi is nothing but that. And that is why when we say that, may you perform your actions selflessly, that is selfishness, the pattern that is built in there. I deliberately bring about a change there and install the idea of selflessness. All retaliation, when somebody does something, I retaliate. That's the natural instinct. And there, I replace it by what we call kshama, the pratipaksha bhavana. So, pratipaksha bhavana is an excellent tool of the yoga shastra. I deliberately bring about an opposite thought, a positive thought. Whenever a negative thought arises, which disturbs my mind, I bring about a positive thought. Thus, I in fact change my built-in intelligence completely. Then it becomes spontaneous. See, what is accomplished through effort to begin with, ultimately becomes effortless. Why? Because my intelligence has been changed. This is my saying anyway, that basically that intelligence DNA itself has been changed. So, DNA comes with built-in intelligence, and that is what conducts the body every moment. The whole body is conducted by the intelligence that is built into DNA. And so every moment hundreds and thousands of chemicals are being generated in the body to respond to every situation that arises, and all of that is done there. And if you, that is where the change has to fundamentally bring about, in the intelligence in the body, or the way vasanas, they call it, you know. So vasanas, samskaras, or habitual error, or tendencies, whatever you call it. So that is called spiritual pursuit, by the way. That is a spiritual pursuit. Other things are spiritual. Other things can be called forms, can be called religion, which is the requirement for this. Religion gives us a form by which we can bring about the transformation. But if religion confines merely to the cheshtas, you know, then also there is a result. Then also phala is there, because cheshta also requires some mind anyway. The idea is that I make my mind deliberately do something that is positive, and that is how I positively install a certain thought, you know, there. And so this is very important. The whole process of religion, all of that is what is to transform the personality. And to the extent that my personality is transformed, to that extent, one is grown. So emotional maturity, or that growth, that's why this is called emotional maturity. Emotion means habitual faculty or impulsive faculty. So that impulsive faculty matures into what we call the spontaneous thing, you know. Anyway, so that is where Hrudayam, when one doesn't have that, what can one accomplish? So anyway, God, that is the projection or intelligence or creation, is manifest as his very heart. And is manifest as what? Prajapati, in the total level. That's what we should be told someplace. So it will come. Okay. That's what Bhashyakara says, going to the previous page. Viragdashakalyah Hrudayam vai brahmeti Hrudyam vai samrat sarvesham bhutanam ayatanam. Vidagdha shakalya. No need even to tell because it's been told earlier, you know. And so vidagdha shakalya. Hrudyam vai brahmedi, foot number 5. Hrudyabhimani prajapati devata hrudyam. Here, the prajapati devata. Who is prajapati? The creator. So creator, creativity is also then another vibhuti of the Lord. And that is the embodiment of that is called prajapati. And that is manifest as the individual level, as the very heart. Hrudayam vai samrat sarvesham bhutanam ayatanam. Then of course Hrudayam is pratishtha, etc. has been said, akasha pratishtha, Hrudayam ayatanam. But then Bhashyakara explains something special that is here. Hrudayam vai samrat sarvesham bhutanam ayatanam. He samrat ayatanam. The abode of all the beings is Hrudayam, this heart. Then continuing further. Nama rupa karmatmakani bhutani hrudayashrayani ityavochama shakalya brahmane hrudaya pratishthani chede tasmat hrudaye hyeva samrat sarvani bhutani pratishthitani bhavante tasmat hrudayam sthitihi ityupasita hrudaye cha prajapatir devata. So nama rupa karmatmakani bhutani hrudaya ashrayani avochama shakalya brahmane. This we have already discussed in shakalya brahmana, that all the beings characterized by nama, rupa and karma, all those beings, chetana and achetana, everything, all of them have their ashraya in hrudaya. All of them have been projected by the heart, and all of them ultimately got dissolved in the heart. All of this we have discussed in the shakalya brahmana. Hrudaya pratishthitani chayati. So when they originate from there and when they resolve there, so that is where they have their abode also. Tasmat. So shakalya brahmanokta yuktehe. So because of the manner in which it has been explained in shakalya brahmana as to how the hrudayam is the abode of everything. Tasmat hrudaye hi eva samrat sarvani bhutani pratishthitani bhavanti. Therefore, he emperor, all the beings have their abode in hrudaya, the heart. Tasmat again. Tasmat. So again Anandagiri says that katham hrudayasya sarvabhutayatanatvam tat prishthatvam cha tadaha namarupaya. How do you say the hrudaya is ayatanam of all the being and pratishtha also, as explained in the ninth brahmana here, shakalya brahmana. Tasmat the shakalya naya paramarsha. This footnote number 3, that tasmat. Tasmat shakalya naya paramarsha. Naya means the rule or the manner in which it was shown in shakalya. That is what is brought to our memory. Tasmat hrudayam sthitihi. Or tasmat hrudaye. Tasmat hrudayam sthitihi upasita. Sthiti is what? Where one is pratishtha. So pratishtha is what? Where one is sthiti. That is called pratishtha. And so therefore, since all the beings have their pratishtha, their ultimate abode in heart, therefore, hrudaya is the abode, sthitihi. A stability or abode, you can say, that which actually sustains everything, supports everything. Bhutanam hrudaya pratishtatve phalitamaha tasmad hrudayam. So that is that one actually. Earlier tasmad was tasmad hrudayeva, and here bhutanam hrudaya pratishtatve phalitamaha tasmad hrudayam sthitihi upasita. So two tasmads are there. The tasmad of footnote number 2 is tasmadi shakalya nyaya paramarsha. Footnote number 3 tasmad is bhutanam hrudaya pratishtatve phalitamaha. So the phalitam is tasmad hrudayam sthitihi upasita. May one meditate upon one's heart as sthitihi, as the one that supports the entire creation. From where the whole entire creation is emerged, by which it is sustained, and to which it goes back, that is heart, that is prajapati. So that creative faculty, sustaining faculty, is represented here at the individual level in the heart. Hrudayacha prajapati devata. Hrudayadhikarane tadhimani prajapati devata brahmatvena chintaniya. So, Prajapati Devata which has a one that has its abode or its body as a heart. So one who resides there, so that is Brahman. This is how one is to meditate. The name is what? Sthitihi. The pratishtha, sthitihi, stability, support. That is the way. So support means from where it emerges, where it sustains, where it goes back. So that very upadana karanam, the very adhishthanam. So that is how one will meditate upon the Prajapati. Is the heart. So this is the Chaturtha Adhyayasya Prathamam Brahmanam. In this manner, the first Brahmana, the fourth chapter is concluded in this way. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Rasmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavatvyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah. Hari Om. Sri Anandagiri introducing this. Purvasmin Brahmane Kanichit Upasanani Jnana Sadhanani Uktani. Purvasmin Brahmane, the first Brahmana. Footnote 5, Shadacharya Brahmane, it's called Shadacharya Brahmana. The first Brahmana, the six Acharyas were there. So, since King Janaka received instructions from six Acharyas, it's called Shadacharya Brahmana. Purvasmin Brahmane. Kanichit Upasanani, put now six, Shat Upasanani to be specific, six Upasanas, Jnana Sadhanani Uktani. So this six Upasanas or the Sadhanam means for Jnanam, for Brahma Jnanam. Idanim Brahmanaha Taihi Jnayasya Jagaradidvara Jnanartham Brahmanantram Avatarayati. Idanim, now in this Brahmana, Brahmana Jnayasya, Taihi Jnayasya. That the Upasanas are meant as a means for Brahma Jnanam. So Brahmana, Brahmana, Taihi Jnayasya, Brahmana, Brahman, that is to be known through the Upasanas. That means Brahman, so Upasanas will become the indirect means of knowing Brahman. Brahma Vidya is the direct means of knowing Brahma. But upasanas are by way of preparation of mind. In that sense, you can say that the upasanas are also a means of knowing Brahma. Jagradidvara. Now in this Brahmana, called Kurcha Brahmana, we will see the delineation of the three states of awareness, Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti. Tadvara, Jnanartham. Idea is that Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti, that tells us all the experiences that we have. And ultimately, Brahman is to be taught only in a negative way, that is by negation. Nantah pragnyam, na bahish pragnyam, no bhayatah pragnyam, na pragnyam, na pragnyanaghanam, na pragnyam, na pragnyam, adushyam avyavaharyam. How everything is negated. Here also we will find that after the three states of awareness, then the description of that, we will find a negation. So, brahmanantaram utarayati, this is the second brahmana. So, this Brahmana Bhashyakara introduces. Janako Haiti. Nahi Talto. No, we should get a new microphone there, aren't we? Talto. Beginning from page 955. Janako Havaideha. Kurchat upavasarpan
उवाच नमस्ते स्तुयाग्निवल्क्य अनुमाशाधीपे सहोवाच यथा वै सम्राट् महान्तमध्वान्तमेष्यन् रथं वा नावं वा समाददीत एवमेव एताभिरुपनिषद्भिः समाहितात्मासे एवं वृन्दारकः आढ्यसन् अधीतवेदः उक्तोपनिषत्कः इतो विमुच्यमानः क्व गमिष्यसीति नाहं तद्भगवन् वेद यत्र गमिष्यामीति अथ वैतेऽहं तद्वक्ष्यामि यत्र गमिष्यसीति ब्रवीतु मे भगवानिति. जनकोह वैदेहः सी फुट्नोट् 1 ऑन दैट पेज 955. द्वितीये ब्राह्मणे जागृत स्वप्न सुषुप्ति मुखान निजम आत्मानं शास्त्यतो राजा यथा विद्युपसन्नवान. द्वितीये ब्राह्मणे दिस ब्राह्मण कूर्च ब्राह्मण जागृत स्वप्न सुप्ति मुखाद मुख सो थ्रू द मीन्स ऑफ जागृत स्वप्न सुषुप्ति निजम आत्मानं शास्ते. सो हियर निजम आत्मानं प्रत्येक आत्मानं शास्ते से याज्ञवल्क्य टीचेस हिम गिव्स हिम उपदेश पर्टेनिंग टू प्रत्येक आत्मा द इनर सेल्फ वन्स ओन सेल्फ. अतः राजा यथाभि उपसन्नवान. सो सिंस दिस इज नॉलेज दैट इज देयरफॉर राजा द किंग यथाविधि उपसन्नवान. देयरफॉर he appropriately or properly approached Sage Yajnavalkya for instruction. The next, Upasananam Sarvesham Aikatmik Jnanishtada Brahma Vidyadhikaratvat Ityeta Dajnochade. Upasananam Sarvesham Aikatmik Jnanishtada. All the Upasanas have the Nishtha in the Aikatmik Jnanam. Aikatma Jnanam meaning the knowledge of Aikyam, the identity with of self and Brahman. Brahma Vidya Adhikartvat Ityedat Adhana Uchyate. So Brahma Vidya Adhikartvat. See the Tika there. Brahma Vidya Prakranastha Upastinam. Because Prakran here is Brahma Vidya. The idea is that this is a Prakran or a chapter or section on Brahma Vidya. We find the Upasanas appearing in the context of Brahma Vidya. Therefore, the Upasanas have a certain role. If the very same Upasana that appeared in some other place, then perhaps the purpose of Upasanas could have been different to actually become the Devata. But here, inasmuch as the Upasanas appear in the context of Brahma Vidya, therefore, so Brahma Vidya Prakranastha Upasthina, the Upasanas which are found in the Brahma Vidya Prakranam, in this section of Brahma Vidya, Tadvara Mukti Phalatvam Maktum. That these Upasanas are means of Mukti through Brahma Vidya. That Upasanas ultimately lead to Brahma Vidya and that way become indirectly the means of Mukti of the Moksha. Mukti Phalatvam Maktum Idam Brahmanam. So this Brahmana tells us, this Brahmana in particular tells us how Upasanas are means of Brahma Vidya. Okay, so that is that. Now going back to the Khandika. Janako Havaideha Kurchat Upavasarpan. So Janaka Vaideha. So he was the king of or emperor of the